What were the planets like 3.8 billion years ago? Have you any idea how long it took the solar system to become what it is today? As for the Earth, it took billions of years for it to become the planet we know. And all planets of the solar system took their time too. Had some distant aliens observed the solar system in the past, they would have noticed the planets were all significantly hotter than they are today, and probably not have bet that any would eventually host life one day. If these aliens had an infinitely powerful telescope and decided to point it to the solar system around 4.1 to 3.8 billion years ago, they would have seen a disproportionately large number of asteroids and comets colliding with the early terrestrial planets in the solar system. Mercury, Venus, Earth, and Mars would have been seen being bombarded by impactors of various sizes. During that period, it was a real mess. But hey, here we are. Life managed to blossom anyway. And we wouldn't probably be here if the late heavy bombardment didn't happen. Life originated and grew strong. And now we can build houses, make love, drink Coke, and attend NBA games. We can also take pictures of Saturn, like this one. We can also land probes on Mars and dig into its surface. And last but not least, we can walk on the moon. We know a lot about our solar system as it is today. But how was it right after the late heavy bombardment? Follow me in this video, and we shall see what can be discovered. Earth. Earth's current form is the result of billions of years of evolution. When our planet first formed, it was extremely hot and consisted mostly of molten magma. Over time, heavy elements sank to the center of Earth, creating a layered structure, with the outer layer being of lighter materials. The planet then developed in three stages: accretion, collision with a protoplanet, and bombardment of asteroids. Earth's early atmosphere likely consisted of hydrogen and helium, and was later enriched with water vapor, ammonia, and carbon dioxide from frequent volcanic eruptions. Eventually, oceans formed, leading to the evolution of primitive life. But during the late bombardment, Earth was suffering under the constant threat of attack from leftover planet-building material. From about 4.1 to 3.8 billion years ago, planetesimals and smaller asteroids slammed into it, scarring its surface. This increasing impact activity, colliding with the Earth as well as the other inner planets, came probably from the movement of the giant planets like Jupiter and Saturn. These sent debris raining down on the smaller and helpless rocky worlds. You won't find evidence of the impacts left behind from the late heavy bombardment stage on Earth. This is because Earth recycles rocks through plate tectonics. In addition, it has undergone significant weathering and volcanism in this time span. And this means these processes have erased any evidence of the late heavy bombardment here on Earth. Earth is like those people who always blame their ex and never take responsibility for their actions. No craters from the late heavy bombardment thanks to Earth's plate tectonics. But if we look elsewhere in the solar system, we can see clear evidence of the impacts, like that jealous ex, craters on the moon, Mercury, and other planets. So even though it's really hard to reconstruct what the Earth looked like right after this terrible period, scientists think they can at least say something about the bigger picture. At that time, our planet was at the beginning of the Archaic period. The Archaic period marked the beginning of Earth's evolution. Plate tectonics caused increased seismic activity and more subduction zones, resulting in more earthquakes, volcanoes, and high levels of carbon dioxide in the atmosphere. With no free oxygen, temperatures were close to modern levels, with liquid water present. With the sun only one-third as bright, global temperatures decreased. This was a time with higher levels of greenhouse gases than ever before. Stromatolites emerged. These are important fossils resulting from the activity of groups of cells in colonies, forming sedimentary rock that began to form 3.8 billion years ago. They were using carbon dioxide and releasing oxygen, eventually creating the breathable air we have today. Despite this, Earth's conditions were too harsh for many species of today. Few could have survived back then. Mars. As concerning the red planet, scientists think Mars looked a lot like Earth in the past, because after the bombardment, Mars had a much denser atmosphere than it currently has. In addition to having much more pleasant temperatures, oceans, and rivers full of water. So where is all the leftover Martian water today? How does knowing where it is help scientists and would-be explorers? Almost all water on Mars today exists as ice, though it also exists in smaller quantities as vapor in the atmosphere. The only place where water ice is visible at the surface is at the North Polar Ice Cap. Some liquid water may occur transiently on the Martian surface today, but is limited to traces of dissolved moisture from the atmosphere and thin films, which are challenging environments for known life. Mars was, for many years, the most hospitable planet for life. But unfortunately, its core cooled very quickly, and this caused the loss of its magnetic field. At that point, there was nothing to protect the atmosphere of the red planet from solar radiation. Particles couldn't be retained in the atmosphere, and they escaped the planet through a process called photoevaporation. Mars was left with a very thin layer of atmosphere. Mercury. In a paper from 2017, scientists claim the bombardment on Mercury caused considerable mechanical and thermal reworking of its silicate reservoirs, crust and mantle. They used a 3D heating model to test the effects of two bombardment scenarios on early Mercury's mantle and crust. Results showed that rare impacts by the largest bodies, around 100 kilometers in diameter, induced extensive melting of Mercury's crust, which reworked the rocks of the crust and generated enough heat to make magnesium-rich melt. This would explain the high magnesium content of the crust observed by the MESSENGER probe, orbiting the planet for more than 4 years. Among its accomplishments, the mission determined Mercury's surface composition, revealed its geological history, and ended when MESSENGER slammed into Mercury's surface. Eventually, the heat flux and crustal melting also helped erase the oldest scars on Mercury, which is consistent with the current observed crater statistics. But now, ladies and gentlemen, fasten your seatbelts because this is really going to blow you away. In fact, what if I told you Venus was quite similar to Earth as it is today, right after the heavy bombardment? Venus. Indeed, the hottest planet of all, with sulfuric acid rains and temperatures exceeding 480 degrees Celsius, was not always the hell it is today. Models show that, after the meteorite bombardment period, several comets full of water fell on the surface. When these comets fell, billions of years ago, the ice they were carrying with them melted and turned into water. If a planet had enough gravity and an atmosphere, that water could stay and become oceans, lakes, and rivers. Unfortunately, we all know how this turned out. The planet soon became hostile to life as we know it, and it still is. Perhaps one of the worst places in the solar system. Now, I know what you're thinking. What about the giant planets? The four gas giants of our solar system, Jupiter, Saturn, Uranus, and Neptune, have likely been impacted by asteroids and comets over time. This is evident from the 1993 Shoemaker-Levy 9 comet, which left a dark vortex on the surface of Jupiter and changes in the coloration of the clouds. These planets have likely looked the same for a long time, and the moons orbiting them may have even changed since their initial discovery. For example, Neptune's largest moon, Triton, may have been captured by the planet's gravity, since it initially wasn't part of Neptune. Planet 5. But wait a minute, how did the late bombardment begin in the first place? Well, several scenarios have proposed to explain such a major event in the solar system's formation. One of the most known hypotheses to have caused the late heavy bombardment is the so-called Planet 5 hypothesis. The Planet 5 hypothesis posits that a fifth terrestrial planet caused the late heavy bombardment when its metastable orbit entered the inner asteroid belt. The hypothetical Planet 5 caused major trouble in the inner asteroid belt. After too many close encounters, the asteroids were sent into Earth's crossing orbit, and the late heavy bombardment began. Planet 5 suddenly disappeared and was likely sent into the depths of the Sun. Scientists believe that the uneven asteroid distribution was necessary to produce the late heavy bombardment. But some say Planet 5 may have caused some trouble on Mars instead and formed the Borealis Basin. Who knows what secrets this hypothetical Planet 5 hides? Before we end the video, however, let's state a major benefit brought on by the late heavy bombardment event. Whether it was comets, asteroids, or failed young planets, scientists think the late heavy bombardment likely played a major role in delivering water to the Earth. The impacts of various objects 3.8 billion years ago would have bludgeoned the planet's surface, vaporizing much of the liquid, but it could also have brought in a great deal of water and organic material. Models suggest that swirling debris from Uranus and Neptune could have flung objects inward, including ice-rich comets. Asteroids too could have deposited water, although some studies suggest that today's asteroids are too dry. Finally, failed planets may have been responsible for the massive impacts on the far side of the moon. Ultimately, it is possible that the late heavy bombardment helped bring the water that sustains life on Earth today. And thus ends the video. Thank you for watching. What would you like to hear next? Let us know in the comments below. I'll see you next time on the channel.